Okay, this is part two of Sweet and Lynch, Time Will Tell for Jason Cherry. We are actually starting this one at the bottom of page three. We're in the solo that Lynch is doing here. The timestamp shortly after 2:42, where we did the... that's where we stopped at the end of part one. So on this, it's 7/8 on the high E. You're going to pick hammer, slide to 10. So there's your hammer, slide to 10, pull off to open. And then go 8E whammy vibrato. So it's... and then the last line on the bottom of page three, we have a whammy up on 8E. And let's see. You're gonna, so whammy up, pull off to 7, pick 5. So it's... and then pick the 5, but whammy up. So... do that slower. Alright, up the tempo. And you may be able to just hammer the... on the last 5 there. 8, pull off to 5 on the high E, and that's gonna go to 8/8 on the B string, down up vibrato. So it's... and then we can go to page 4, it's our last page. Upstroke 5, let me play the riff. Awesome little riff. It's not always about quantity, right? You could take 4 notes, man, and just make them your own, make them really cool sounding. So it's out of the pentatonic scale. We're going up on 5E, down on 8B, pull off to 5, and then up down on 7G, pinch harmonic the second one, do a whole step bend. And that's why I'm saying up down, because it's a pinch on the last one and it's kind of hard to pinch on an upstroke. So. 2:48, we got this quick 3-note thing. Passes so fast you can barely hear it. It's or, up on 5E, 7G bend, down, up on 5B. So, and then this part's killer, man. It's... oops. Like, Lynch will throw in, like, an open high E sometimes in a weirder spot, you know? You don't get that a lot with guitar players. Like, they try to keep everything uniform. But he's using that, you know, I call it a drone note. But it's really cool. You want to up down on this. Start on 12E with the up, and then down on 10B. Same thing, but 13 and 10. And then back to 12-10. Right? Don't move the arm. Keep it with the distancing of your wrist. The motion, I should say. Up on the open high E, and that's that E I was just talking about earlier. So, and then 12 slide to 15 on the B, or on the E, and then go to 12B. So there's your 15 slide, 12B, down, up on 13E, down on 12B, up on 12E. So we have... awesome. After that, alternate pick, 15, 13, 13, 15 on the B. And then an open G. There's another example of where he'll throw in an open. So, if you need to switch up fingering there, Jason, that's fine. I actually didn't write it for this part for that reason. You may want to go, and then first and third. So, and then we're going to go 15, 17B to 13E. And that's up, down, up. And then kind of traditional riffs, Lynch style here. It's you'll do 12, pick on the E, hammer 13, pull 12, hammer 13, pull 12. So now Lynch isn't thinking about how many of those he's going to throw in there. So at the end of the day, you want it to feel right. So try not to overanalyze it if you don't have to. And then 15E, pull to 12, hammer 13, pull and hammer 15. So it's, so we have. And then this one here, 12, 13, 12, 13, 12, that's all technique. It's picking the initial note with an up and then down on 16B. And this is a trademark Lynch riff. That could also be, but we got to pick one. That's where I picked. And so, three times. Now I noticed on the third one, didn't sound like the 16 was in there, but if you want to keep it consistent without getting confused, you can, you know. Well, I think in reality he was going, but pick and choose on that, but that's a killer riff. 20 on the high E, we're going to bend that. Don't release it. Just take the pick, land on it, come back down, hit it. Go to 22 on the high E. Whole step. And then take it a half step higher. So it's... and then the fret 24. I wish this guitar had 24 frets, but you need this note. Dang it. I can't even tell you because I don't have the 24 fret. Let's see, 15, 17, 19, 20, 22. It's hard to say, brother. Now I'm thinking it was a 24 with a bend on top of it because it was a high note. I'll double check that for you. And then, so that's how the solo ends. He's whammy in the note. If you don't have 24 frets, because a lot of people don't, you can keep it in key there by bending fret 22. And use the whammy, right? Coolness. Repeat, section 1, section 5, and section 2. And then when the song ends, there's two little parts here that I want to show you. You can pick and choose. You can use the octave, which is being layered in here. You know that vocal line that Mike Sweet's singing, that Lynch is doing the octave with, would be, which is 12 mute 14 ADG, down up, down up. Keep in mind when you're doing the down up concept, you may want to make sure you're muting that low E. I'm actually muting the B as well as the E. All these mutes coming into play. And this is where it matters more, because if you're doing downstrokes, you have more time to pay attention to, oops, I don't want to hit it. But it's a good habit. Mute all around these notes to keep your playing clean. Down, up, down, up. Or the chord. Open A, second fret, D, just a power chord. I'll take my thumb and mute the low E. Or, you know, but I think it's the open position there. All right, Jason. Appreciate it, dude. Had fun doing it. Lynch, one of my faves. Mike Sweet, one of my faves. I mean, you know how to pick him, brother. So if you have any questions, let me know. And once again, thank you.